After taking over as the new Maharashtra Chief Minister, Uddhav Thackeray chairing his first cabinet meeting. Besides focusing on secularism, this new government has put farmers' issue in its key agenda. Addressing a press conference after the meeting, Uddhav Thackeray even announced key decisions taken by the government, which includes rebuilding the Shivaji Fort in Raigarh. In its common minimum program, the Agadi government has announced setting up two coordination committees, which will help in smooth functioning. The first panel will within government and include chief minister and ministers. Second panel involving alliance partners will guide the government on key policy issues. And Uddhav Thackeray taking oath as the new chief minister of Maharashtra, becoming the first member of the Thackeray clan to occupy that top position. Now, besides Uddhav Thackeray, six ministers were also sworn in at Mumbai's Shivaji Park. Details in this special report.
Thackeray Raj begins. Maharashtra gets its first chief minister from the Thackeray clan that has often run the state through a remote. The star-studded political extravaganza unfolded at Mumbai's Shivaji Park as Uddhav took oath before the 70,000-strong, jam-packed crowd. Uddhav came dressed in saffron to take oath from the exact place where his father, Bala Sahib, launched the Shiv Sena 53 years ago. Uddhav began by paying tribute to Chhatrapati Shivaji. And then took oath in the name of God.
Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharajana Vandan Karun. Ani Maja Ayi Vadlanche Smaran Karun.
The new chief minister has got a lean team for now. Eknath Shinde and Subhash Desai from Shiv Sena, Jayant Patil and Chagan Bhujbal from NCP, Bala Sahib Thorat and Nitin Raut from the Congress are the other ministers. Many prominent political leaders, including Devendra Fadnavis, DMK Chief MK Stalin, MP Chief Minister Kamal Nath, and bigwigs from the corporate world, attended the ceremony. MNS Chief and Uddhav's estranged cousin Raj Thackeray greeted the newly appointed Chief Minister. A rare Thackeray photo op that was not to be, as Uddhav got crowded on the stage. As the oath ceremony ended, massive celebrations erupted at the Sena Bhavan. The skyline of Mumbai was lit up with fireworks.
Uddhav Thackeray's coalition government will follow common minimum program. The Hindutva has no mention in it. Issues like farmers' distress, unemployment, health, etc. takes the precedence in it. The glittering swearing-in ceremony is over. Now, the real task of the governance awaits Shiv Sena chief. Sahil Joshi in Mumbai for India Today.
Uddhav Thackeray has been sworn in as 18th chief minister of the state of Maharashtra, but he was not born a politician. From a wildlife photographer to a reluctant politician to now the chief minister of Maharashtra, this is the life of Uddhav Thackeray.
Me, Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray.
Uddhav Thackeray has risen to the throne of Maharashtra riding the tiger. But the first Thackeray to become the chief minister is everything his father wasn't. Balasaheb Thackeray was a fiery orator and a firebrand leader. Uddhav, on the other hand, is soft-spoken and rarely provocative. Born on July 27, 1960, Uddhav Thackeray grew up with interests unlike his father. When Thackeray Sr., himself a cartoonist and an artist, was busy building the Shiv Sena, Uddhav was pursuing a career that was anything but politics. A graduate from the JJ Institute of Applied Arts, Mumbai, Uddhav pursued his first passion, photography. He travelled across the world to capture landscape, people and wildlife. It was in 2001 municipal elections that Balasaheb Thackeray decided to bring his son into active politics. A year later, Uddhav, then 40 years old, scripted victory in the BMC elections. In 2003, Uddhav was made the working president of the Shiv Sena ahead of the Balasaheb's nephew Raj, who till then many had thought would make a natural successor.
When he won that 2012 election and Raj Thackeray was not able to make the impact that he had hoped, I think then Uddhav Thackeray believed his moment had come. And once his father then passed away, the party was much more willing in 2012 to accept him than they were a decade before that.
Uddhav took over as Sena chief in 2012 after his father's demise.
Aaj bhi mai bhale koi kuch bhi kahe lekin kisi bhi pad ke liye mai apne aap ko ye nahi manta ki ye mera sapna hai.
Since then, Uddhav has led Sena to many ups and downs.
The personality of the party has definitely changed because the leadership had changed. I mean, leadership of Bal Thackeray was completely different. He used to call the shots. I mean, his word used to be the final word.
While the Shiv Sena joined the BJP government in Maharashtra after the 2014 assembly polls, the party was reduced to being a junior partner. Now, after forming a government in alliance with NCP and Congress, Uddhav will try to grow his party beyond its traditional areas of influence. Bureau Report, India Today.
First Balasaheb and then Uddhav Thackeray always holding the reins of power from the back seat. But all that changed now because Uddhav Thackeray has now become the first from the powerful clan to occupy a government position. However, the 59-year-old Uddhav Thackeray has his task cut out from managing a coalition of three parties with completely different ideologies to also addressing the concerns of the farmers. Uddhav Thackeray has a tight rope to walk. How his life is going to be as a politician, take a look.
Me, Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray, Ishwar Saksha Shapat Gheto Ki.
Dressed in glittering saffron kurta, Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray took oath as the 18th Chief Minister of Maharashtra.
Sarvabhaumata va ekatmata unnat rakhin.
A first for the Thackeray family, who turned out in style for the grand occasion. Immediately after swearing in, the Thackeray family greeted the 70,000-strong crowd. Uddhav hugged his son Aditya and shook hands with his wife. Once comrade and now his political rival Raj Thackeray too attended. Uddhav also gave a bear hug to Maharashtra Nav Nirman Sena chief and nephew Raj Thackeray. It was a dream come true for the Shiv Senics. They lit the Mumbai skies bright.
ये तो सिर्फ बाकी है, अभी पूरी महाराष्ट्र पूरी दुनिया बाकी है.
बहुत बहुत खुशी है 25 साल के बाद शिव सैनिक के सम्माननीय पक्ष प्रमुख उद्धव जी ठाकरे ये महाराष्ट्र के मुख्यमंत्री पद पर विराजमान हुए. हम सभी शिव सैनिकों में बहुत ही आनंद का वातावरण है.
After the month-long political tug of war, these were moments every Sainik will cherish.
हम लोग को बहुत खुशी हो गई. हमारा मुख्यमंत्री शिवसेना का उद्धव ठाकरे बन गया तो बहुत खुशी हो गई.
20 साल के बाद 20 साल के बाद बाळासाहेब ठाकरे का सपना साकार हुआ. सन्माननीय उद्धव जी ठाकरे साहब ये महाराष्ट्र के मुख्यमंत्री.
In the audience was also a Balasaheb lookalike.
अरे मैं ऐसा बन बिन के आता नहीं है. ये मैं ओरिजिनल है. ओरिजिनल
सब लोग आपके साथ सेल्फी निकालते हैं.
सेल्फी निकालते, फोटो निकालते, उनको एक लगता है दिल से कि मुझे देखे तो कि बालासाहेब ठाकरे हिंदू हृदय सम्राट बालासाहेब ठाकरे की उनको याद आती है.
From Shivaji Park, the Thackerays headed to the Siddhivinayak Temple to seek blessings from Lord Ganpati. The journey from Matoshri to Mantralay took 53 years.
After outmaneuvering the BJP, Uddhav Thackeray now will have to prove his credentials. The biggest challenge for Uddhav Thackeray will be to steer an alliance of ideologically different parties like the Congress and NCP. With camera person Vaibhav Kangutkar, Kamlesh Sutar in Mumbai for India Today.
And history was scripted at Mumbai Shivaji Park when Uddhav Thackeray took that oath as Maharashtra Chief Minister. However, the event also grabbed a lot of eyeballs. Why? Because of those who did not attend the event and were conspicuous by their absence. Congress Chief Sonia Gandhi, her son and MP Rahul Gandhi did not attend despite the grand old party being a part of this Maha Agadi alliance. Take a look at this special report.
A grand stage, an iconic location, many political heavyweights, the richest Indian, and nearly 1 lakh people. History was scripted at Shivaji Park when Uddhav Thackeray took over the reins of Maharashtra.
Me, Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray.
But more than those who attended, the ones who missed it grabbed the eyeballs. It revealed that at the end of it, the alliance of Shiv Sena, NCP and the Congress is, after all, a coalition of contradictions. If the HD Kumaraswamy swearing in last year was a mega show of opposition unity, Uddhav's was nowhere near it. Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath and DMK Chief MK Stalin were the only prominent faces from outside Maharashtra. Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi and Manmohan Singh, who were personally invited by Uddhav's son and MLA Aditya Thackeray, gave the event a miss. Sonia sent a letter congratulating Uddhav.
Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi, why are they not going for this function? Why does, you've seen Rahul Gandhi going to Bengaluru in Kumaraswamy swearing in and shaking hands and waving to the people. He's simply, he doesn't want to be standing on the side of Uddhav Thackeray.
Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee were absent, both probably wary of upsetting their Muslim votes. Mamata issued a statement saying, Maharashtra is BJP mukt now, Jharkhand will be next. Uddhav Thackeray's swearing-in ceremony, while grand in every sense, also exposed how the alliance he leads is a coalition of contradictions. The Shiv Sena and Congress may have reached a compromise by omitting Hindutva from the common minimum program. They remain allies, suspicious of each other. Bureau Report, India Today.
And hours after Uddhav Thackeray was sworn in as the new Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Bharatiya Janata Party launched a scathing attack on Uddhav Thackeray, calling him a Godse Bhakt. Now, with the Maha Agadi Alliance's Common Minimum Programme mentioning secularism, BJP's MP GVL Narasimha Rao said Uddhav Thackeray and his MLAs have pledged their loyalty to the Sultanate, referring to the Gandhi family. Continuing his attack, Rao also said that Sena should rename its mouthpiece Samna as Sonia Nama. Now remember, the Mahavikas Agadi in his Common Minimum program have mentioned its commitment to secular values enshrined in the constitution. Now from Shiv Sena to Sadhvi Pragya Thakur, the opposition launching a scathing attack on BJP MP Pragya Thakur for her remarks on Mahatma Gandhi's assassin Nathuram Godse. Now with the Congress and other parties set to move a censure motion against her in the Lok Sabha, Bharatiya Janata Party ally, the JDU, demanding sending the matter to Ethics Committee of the Lok Sabha. Facing flak, BJP decided to even move swiftly and punish the MP by Pragya Thakur, who was axed from Rajnath Singh-led Parliamentary Defence Committee. She was also barred from attending BJP's parliamentary party meetings during the ongoing winter session. Now this, even as Bhopal Member of Parliament herself defended, saying she did not speak on Godse, but in fact was reacting on Uddham Singh as a claim that the truth will come out. Now also condemning Pragya Thakur in the strongest word, Defence Minister Rajnath Singh called her remark unacceptable in the Lok Sabha. But the opposition clearly not impressed, staging a walkout from the house.
political storm in parliament. Opposition on its feet over BJP Bhopal MP Pragya Singh Thakur lauding Gandhi killer Nathuram Godse as a patriot on Wednesday.
Honorable.
The Congress walked out of the Lok Sabha after an angry outburst promising a censure motion. Congress MP Rahul Gandhi called the Malegaon blast accused a terrorist herself.
Sir, ye sadan ke andar hamare Mahatma Gandhi ji je rashtrapita ki jo hattakari hai wo hattakari ko deshbhakt kehlata hai. Ye sadan ka chup rahega, ye sarkar ka chup rahega, ye sarkar ko khul kar kehna chahiye. Ye Nathuram Godse panti hai, ye Gandhi panti hai.
AIMIM's OAC promised to move a privilege motion against Pragya, accusing her of Godse giri.
Ab isse badi badtameezi, behudgi, father of the nation se aur kya ho sakti hai? The parliament ke privilege ke khilaf isliye humne aaj speaker ko privilege motion diya hai. Aur unka ye bolna bilkul jhoot hai ke wo kisi aur ke bare mein soch kar keh rahi thi.
The BJP on a back foot penalized Pragya by axing her from the parliamentary panel on defense, with Minister Rajnath Singh slamming her on the floor of the Lok Sabha.
Nathuram Godse ko deshbhakt kahe jane ki baat to dur. Main samajhta hu ki yadi deshbhakt manne ki kisi ki soch hai, hum is soch ko hi puri tarah se hamari party condemn karti hai, hamari sarkar bhi condemn karti hai.
We have decided that she'll be removed from the Consultative Committee of Defence, and in this session, she will not be allowed to participate in the Parliamentary Party meeting.
Facing BJP heat, Pragya claimed that charges against her are motivated. Pragya, a repeat offender, had called Godse a patriot even during the Lok Sabha polls.
Nathuram Godse deshbhakt the, hain aur rahenge. Aisa bolne unko atankwadi kehne wale log. स्वयं के गिरेवान में झांक के देखें, अब की चुनाव में ऐसे लोगों को जवाब दे दिया जाएगा.
She had even justified 26/11 martyr Hemant Karkare's death.
ऐसा देश सर्वनाश होगा. ठीक सवा महीने में सूतक लगता है. जब किसी की मृत्यु होती है या जन्म होता है तो सूतक लगता है. तो जिस दिन मैं गई थी उस दिन इसके सूतक लग गया.
Prime Minister Modi had expressed anger over Pragya's earlier Godse remarks. A red-faced BJP may now mull, showing her the door.